the way to learn Chinese. Chinese pot, Chinese pot, Chinese pot. That's the way to learn Chinese.
Hello there, elementaries. My name is Ken Carroll. We have a lesson in spoken Mandarin.
Hi, I'm Jenny.
Hello, Jenny. Tell us about today's lesson.
It's a clown.
A clown?
Yeah.
It's a clown?
We're not joking.
We're not joking. It's about a clown.
Yes, it's about a clown.
About a clown. I see. Not just any old clown. This is a scary clown.
Oh, they're all scary, Ken.
Really?
I don't get the entertaining part of it.
Really? You find clowns scary?
Yeah. I need years of therapy after seeing a clown. Yes.
Wow. Okay, this is going to be interesting to watch Jenny's reaction to this clown.
Yes.
How do you say the word clown in Chinese?
小丑.
The tones are?
Two third tones.
Mm. Third and third. Let's hear it again, please.
小丑。And very interesting meaning.
Oh, that's 丑. That's like
ugly.
Ugly.
Little ugly. Yes.
So the way to say clown in Chinese literally is the little ugly.
Yes.
Wow. Interesting.
Yeah.
Ugly is normally an adjective, but in this case, it's obviously a noun. Or little ugliness, perhaps.
Yes.
Who knows? That's a really interesting thing. Now, traditionally, the clown in Chinese culture is not the same as the clown in Western culture.
Sure.
But there's a little bit of detail in there that we can look at in a moment to explain the relationship between the two. But let's listen to the dialogue three times, and then we'll explain it in a bit more detail.
好。对话第一遍。
宝宝，你看这是谁？
嗨，小朋友。
妈妈，怪物。哦，别怕，这是小丑。
是啊，我是你的好朋友。你看，我的鼻子是红的。
你是坏人，走开，走开。
第二遍。
宝宝，你看这是谁？
嗨，小朋友。
妈妈，怪物。哦，别怕，这是小丑。
是啊，我是你的好朋友。你看，我的鼻子是红的。
你是坏人，走开，走开。
第三遍。
宝宝，你看这是谁？
嗨，小朋友。
妈妈，怪物。哦，别怕，这是小丑。
是啊，我是你的好朋友。你看，我的鼻子是红的。
你是坏人，走开，走开。
Okay.
It's childhood flashback.
It is, yeah. Let's translate it, see, and see.
好。宝宝，你看这是谁？
Hey, look, who's that?
宝宝，你看这是谁？
Wow, look, who's that?
宝宝，你看这是谁？嗨，小朋友。
Hello, little friend.
嗨，小朋友。
Hello, little friend.
嗨，小朋友。妈妈，怪物。
Mommy, there's a monster.
妈妈，怪物。
Mommy, a monster.
妈妈，怪物。哦，别怕，这是小丑。
Oh, don't be scared. This is just a clown.
哦，别怕。这是小丑。
Don't be scared, that's a clown.
哦，别怕，这是小丑。是啊，我是你的好朋友。你看，我的鼻子是红的。
Yeah, I'm your friend. Look at my nose, it's red.
是啊，我是你的好朋友。你看，我的鼻子是红的。
Yeah, I'm your good friend. Look at my red nose.
是啊。我是你的好朋友，你看 我的鼻子是红的。你是坏人，走开，走开。
You're bad. Go away, go away.
你是坏人，走开，走开。
You're a baddie. Go away, go away.
你是坏人，走开，走开。
Well, there's interesting differences culturally here in a lot of instances. So let's take a look at the first one.
Yeah.
The first sentence was,
宝宝，你看这是谁？
Now, this is a parent addressing a child as
对，宝宝，宝宝。
Now, 宝宝 would probably translate best as sort of baby or infant
yes.
or something like that.
Mm.
Now, in Chinese, you call the infant
a child
宝宝, and you would address them directly.
对。
As 宝宝,
宝宝、
and you could talk about your 宝宝、
yes.
about your child. But in English, we don't really do that.、
Mm.
We don't say child or infant or baby.、
Mm.
So I actually left that out in the translation.、You're more likely to just、use the child's name or just get directly to you know, the、observation. Now, in this case, it was a question for the 宝宝, and that was,
你看这是谁?你看这是谁?
So take a look. Who's this? Who's coming? It's a rhetorical question, of course.
Yeah.
Who's this coming? Now, and well, who is it?
是个小丑.
小丑is the clown. So he addresses the kid as,
Hi, 小朋友。小朋友
Now, 小朋友 literally translated, of course, means little friend, but that's, again, culturally how we do it in Chinese.、
Yeah.
You address a child as, very small child as a 宝宝 and a slightly bigger child as a
小朋友
小朋友 literally translated little friend.、
How cute.
Now, it's interesting that, you know, Chinese has these words, these kind of categories,、and it's very common to...、Now, in this case, the 小朋友 is not at all impressed.
妈妈怪物
Right.
So, 怪物
Now, 怪物 being a
monster.
Tell us about those two characters, 怪物
Yeah. The first character 怪 means strange, weird.
Yes.
物 means a thing or a creature.
A creature.
A weird creature.
A weird creature. In fact, it means more like thing, doesn't it? You have 动物 but you...
对。
Yeah.
Greetings, everyone, and welcome to Chinese Pod Trivia. Our first question is, how long will it take you to become an intermediate Chinese speaker using the Chinese Pod app?Is it A, the rest of your life, B, you should already be an intermediate speaker, C, 3 months, or D, ChinesePod has an app?
You should already be in...
Ooh, that is incorrect. The correct answer is C, 3 months. That's right. Head over to ChinesePod.com now to register for your access to over 4,000 lessons. Get the ChinesePod app now on Google Play or the App Store.
Okay, so weird creature is a pretty good translation. Weird thing or weird creature.
怪物
怪物 Wow, monster, basically.
That's my reaction to
clown. Yeah.
There you go.
Now, of course, you tell the child, don't be scared. It's fairly straightforward, we say.
别怕,别怕。
Yeah, so don't be scared. That's a clown.
这是小丑,这是小丑。
Yeah, now the clown pipes in. He's trying to make friends with,
yes.
With the child. And he says,
是啊,我是你的好朋友。你看,我的鼻子是红的。
That's kind of taking liberties, isn't it? I'm your good friend. How could he be good friends when they just clap
when
eyes
When just call you 怪物,是吧?
I'm not your 怪物, I'm your...
好朋友 good friend.
Yeah. Now, look, my nose is red.
你看,我的鼻子是红的。你看,我的鼻子是红的。
Now, this kid is not impressed. He thinks the guy looks pretty evil, pretty bad, pretty nasty. So he calls him a...
坏人,坏人。
Now, this is an interesting expression. Tell us something about this word, 坏。
坏... means bad or evil.
Yes.
然后坏人, It's someone who is bad or evil.
Right. Mm. And 坏了 can also mean broken, right?
Yeah, it's a very loose, generic term.
Yeah, so, yeah. But it's all negative.
Yes.
Right? 坏了, it's something is broke.
对。
坏人, would be the baddies in a movie or something.
Yes.
Right. Yeah. Mm. And it's more flexible than in English. You'd call the baddies in a movie 坏人, but you could also say it to, you know, someone in the schoolyard if they did something naughty or whatever. Okay, there you go. And giving someone the marching orders.
走开,走开。
Literally meaning walk open, right?
是的。
走, walk, 开 as to open.
Open.
Literally. Sometimes, you know, stuff doesn't translate literally. So 走开 means go away.
Yeah. And Ken, you mentioned something about the last sentence being very direct.
Yes, yes, yes.
A child telling the clown in the face, 你是坏人.
Yeah.
But in China, I notice a lot of kids are quite straightforward.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, maybe they've been taught to be more forward and more direct these days. I'm not really sure.
Only child.
Yeah.
Being quite spoiled and indulgent.
This one is pretty direct. You know, he said, look, you're a bad guy. Go away. Even in English, where kids are more open, slightly more direct. That would sound pretty tough, but fair play to the kid.
Yeah, and I've seen actually little kids being even more direct than this.
Okay.
I know a kid, a child, a family friend.
Yeah.
Every time a stranger or someone he loosely knows tries to hug him or kiss him, he says, you're ugly, go away.
Oh my God.
Yeah. He tells people in the face, you're ugly, go away.
Oh, right. Well, I know what I would say to him. But anyway, I won't repeat that here. Okay. Let's listen to this three more times, because another thing I want to mention here, if we could. So let's have a listen.
好。对话第一遍。
宝宝，你看这是谁？
嗨，小朋友。
妈妈，怪物。哦，别怕，这是小丑。
是啊，我是你的好朋友。你看，我的鼻子是红的。
你是坏人，走开，走开。
第二遍。
宝宝，你看这是谁？
嗨，小朋友。
妈妈，怪物。哦，别怕，这是小丑。
是啊，我是你的好朋友。你看，我的鼻子是红的。
你是坏人，走开，走开。
第三遍。
宝宝，你看这是谁？
嗨，小朋友。
妈妈，怪物。哦，别怕，这是小丑。
是啊，我是你的好朋友。你看，我的鼻子是红的。
你是坏人，走开，走开。
I just want to explore this question of the clown.
小丑。
小丑。Now,there is no real equivalent, I believe,
in Chinese culture.
However, in the Peking opera style or the Shanghai opera and the others, there is a character that also uses the word
丑, ugly.
What is he called?
丑角, 丑角。
丑角。
对。
Now, hence the link with the clown, as in 小
丑。小
丑。Now, what role did the 丑角 play in Peking opera?
Well, actually, 角 means role, a character.
Okay.
So it's the ugly character. It can be fun, or it can be quite sinister.
Okay.
And it always has a, like a clownish makeup, like a face.
Yes. So a clown could even be evil. right? Or it could be just goofy and silly.
Yes.
Or it could be amusing in a funny sense or another way.
Yeah.
So that's the link between it. But, you know, the clown, you know, the Ronald McDonald type clowns and that clown, it's actually quite a big variation. But there is some kind of link there. So if you use the word 小丑, it will conjure up a Western clown in that sense.
Yes.
So there you go.
Interesting lesson.
Indeed. All right. Now, you can explore all this language. You know where, ChinesePod.com. Go there, do that, and consolidate your learning. Right now, however, we're going
to say 再见.
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.ChinesePod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number
0683.
So just go to www.ChinesePod.com/0683 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.ChinesePod.com/0683.